Hi, this is JP from Now the Lights Over Arkham. Welcome to another Marvel Champions LCG deck testing video. This time I am testing a Nova Justice deck against the Taskmaster scenario from The Rise of the Red Skull on standard difficulty. I decided to try out some of the newer cards that key off of the aerial keyword or trait on cards, so I also haven't played Nova yet in Justice, which is my favorite, one of my favorite aspects, so I decided to try Nova out in Justice. And because this scenario has a lot of side schemes in play usually, then Justice seemed like the good way to go. But let's first look at Nova's Justice deck. Okay, and we are over on marvelcdb.com, and here is my Nova Aerial Justice deck. First off, I am running 8 allies and some older, some newer allies. So we have Eros. This is in the deck just because I wanted one cheap 2 thwart ally into the deck, and Eros seemed like a good choice for that, and this helps us confuse some enemies if we need to. Then because we have a lot of side schemes in this scenario, Jessica Jones seemed like a really good card to add here. We have Nick Fury, of course, but one of the newer basic allies is Snow Guard. This is a really flexible ally. You can basically choose to either run her as an attack ally, a thwarting ally, or a defensive ally that will just take damage and deal retaliate, so a really interesting ally to have. Then one of the newer cards from the Ironheart pack is Wasp, and this can be only played if you are a champion and Nova is a champion. Wasp ignores the guard keyword and patrol keyword and crisis icon, so this is a really flexible ally to have with one attack and 2 thwart, so, and cost of 2, so really interested to see how Wasp functions. Then we have Vikan. This is just to have an ally that deals damage. Then Wraith, we can ignore some boost effects, which could be useful in some situations. Then Agile Flight is a newer card from Star-Lord, which I haven't used yet. So this keys off from the aerial trait, so we can remove a total up to 5 threat from among schemes if we have the aerial trait. It is a costly event, but it's a really strong event for removing threats. Then one way or another, we might want to see some side schemes in this scenario, especially to get those captive allies into play. So we can search the encounter deck for a side scheme and put it into play and draw cards, so this is a really good card for this scenario. Then we have Yaw and Roll, which is from the Nova's own pack. And after your hero thwarts, remove 3 threat from a scheme, so you can only play this in area if you have aerial trait. So again, king of the aerial. Seems like a good card to try out. Then we have the basic resources, the Power of Justice. And I added one helicarrier to get some cheapening effects. Then we have Endurance to boost the health up a bit. Skilled Investigator draws us cards when we defeat side schemes, so this is a good mix. And lastly, Under Surveillance to keep the main scheme in check, so we don't have to worry about it that much while we're dealing with the side schemes. So that is the deck. Let's hop back over to the scenario. Okay, so we have set up the scenario. We have the Hydra Patrol in play already. Then we have these captive allies here. So once we draw the captured by Hydra side schemes, we draw one of those at random and put it underneath. And then we must not forget about the forced response on the main scheme. So there is only one scheme on the main scheme, so forced response after resolving step one of the villain phase. Each player in hero form must choose to either place one threat here or take one damage. And also the Taskmaster has the after player changes to hero form, they discard the top card of the encounter deck and take damage equal to the number of boost icons on that card. So we will try to avoid going into alter ego that much. We'll see how that goes. That is all I wanted to say before we start, so let's get started. Okay, and we are ready to begin. So we'll draw our opening hand of 6 cards. And I'm hoping to see one wild icon so we can fetch the helmet if needed. Well, we didn't get any wild icons. I think we will just fetch the helmet plate with strength. Then go from there. So, well, we'll actually just... well, we got another Agile for Light, that didn't help us. We'll go with these. Okay, so we'll use the Alter Ego action first. So spend one resource of any type, search your deck and discard pile for Supernova Helmet, add it to your hand, and if we would use a wild resource, we also would put it into play, but we're not able to get the wild resource. There aren't that many in the deck, except the connecting to the world mind and the power of justices, but... we were not lucky enough to draw one of those. Where is the helmet? Okay. Supernova helmet. And yeah, well, actually we'll use another card to play that, not strength. Okay. Shuffle our deck. We'll play the helmet and we'll use Agile Flight to play it. We still don't need to remove that much threat. Actually, we want to keep that, so I'm using the light. Snow Guard is a bit too costly for this hand, so I'll use that to play the Supernova Helmet. We'll flip to hero mode. I will use one way or another. We will search the encounter deck. We'll take one captured by Hydra. Then we will draw 3 cards. So this comes into play. So when revealed, place one random set aside captive ally face down beneath this scheme. When this scheme is defeated, the player who defeated it takes that ally into hand and removes the scheme from the game. So we'll just grab these are shuffled, so it is random. We don't know which ally is captured. Next we will use Supernova Helmet and Strength to play Agile Flight. Of course, we have the aerial with the helmet, and we will remove 5 threat from schemes amongst in play. So we'll just remove 5 from here, remove this from the game, get this into our hand. So we get White Tiger. White Tiger is a thwarting ally. So after you play White Tiger from your hand, spend mental resource, remove 3 threat from a scheme. So we might as well play it and do this. we will remove 2 from here. This is defeated. Then, oh yeah, before we do any of that, I of course forgot this. So we add 1 threat here. We'll check the boost icons. We get 2. Just check it on Nova. So we are set with these forced responses. And yeah, we have to discard each player searches the encounter deck and discard pile for a Hydra mini and puts it in play. So we'll just do that next. I think we don't want a Hydra soldier right away. Hydra regular. That's 1 threat. Don't have any other good choices. The Hydra regular is a good choice because we can defeat it immediately. So we add 1 threat here with the inside 1. Then I'll just attack. Yeah, so I'll attack for 1 and an attack for 1. This is defeated. We ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get Genius, Light Speed, Flight, one way or another. Nick Fury and Weaken. Okay. Did I even draw the 3 cards? I can't remember. Maybe I did. I actually didn't. So, well, it is what it is. We didn't really need those for this round. Okay, well, we'll continue from here. So we'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat to the main scheme. Taskmaster attacks. I will defend with Nova. So 2 plus 2 is 4. So we defend for 2. We take 2 damage. We get an encounter card. It is gang up, so Taskmaster attacks again. We are taking a lot of damage, but it is what it is. I think I have 2. Well, I have 6, so I'm not taking 6. So I'll just take with Nova. Take 3 more damage. Down to 3. We might need to go heal. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, well, we want to play Nick Fury to draw cards. I'm using Vika, Light Speed Flight, and Genius. We'll draw 3 cards. Unleash Nova Force, Yaw, and Roll. And Endurance. So I'll play one way or another. We're search the encounter deck for captured by Hydra. There is still 1 in there, so that is good. Unfortunately, we discarded 2, so we can't get the others fast unless we loop the encounter deck. Maybe 2 is enough. We'll get this into play. Just 5 threats. Then I think White Tiger and Nick Fury will just defeat this. So we had 1 random here, and it is Moon Knight. So after you play Moon Knight from your hand, spend 2 wild resource, draw 2 cards. We don't have a wild resource, so we'll just put it into play. We have our ally slots maxed out. And I think I will play Endurance. And I will gain 3 health. So that is that. Moon Knight will hit for 2 damage here. And actually, yeah, well, I didn't use the I'll use this to use for the Moon Knight, so we draw 2 cards. Okay, I can't play Eros. I play Lightning Speed. With Eros and Yarn and Roll to remove 3 from here. That is our turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 5. Energy, Unleash Nova Force, Yarn and Roll, Agile Flight, and Yarn and Roll. So we have all the threat removal we ever need. We go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat here. Taskmaster attacks, Nick Fury will defend, Nick Fury will get defeated. We get an encounter card, which is Mimicry. Discard the top 5 cards of your deck. If an attack card was discarded this way, Taskmaster attacks you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pot shot is an attack, so... That is unfortunate, and we missed Wasp also. So, I will defend 2 against 2, so we take 1 damage because of 1 boost icon. But that is all we can do, so that is that round. Let's go to the next round. I think, again, I forgot to draw the cards for them. It is what it is. I'm just playing horribly, but it is what it is. Okay, well, I think White Tiger will defend this round, but Moon Knight will hit for 2 damage. Then I will just play the Agile Flight with you on roll and energy. Just remove 1 threat, it doesn't really matter. Yeah. We'll keep the rest. Nothing much else to do this round. We actually go to Alter Ego so we can heal a bit. We ready up. We draw. I think I'll keep the Yoan roll. No, I'll discard it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards. Connect to the world mind. Doesn't count towards our hand size. We'll draw another one under surveillance. Skilled investigator, the power of justice, force field projection, Miss Marvel, unleash Nova Force. We'll go to the villain phase, we add 1 threat here. Oh yeah, this was when resolving it, so there's... I removed like 5 threats, so we don't mind that, so... We add 1 threat, we add a second threat. Oh no, we are not in hero form, okay. Taskmaster schemes for 1 plus if you are in hero 4, we are not, so we get 1 here. Encounter card for this turn is advanced, so 2 plus 2 is 4, so we are at 6 threat. Yeah, that's okay, but that is that round. Let's go to the next round. We will heal for 3. We'll go to the hero form. Now we'll flip this. Take 1. Just take the 1. I'll put skilled investigator into play. I play Miss Marvel with these three. I will play under surveillance with these two. And I'll just vote for one here. And that is it. We will ready up. Draw back up to 5. Hot shot. One way or another, Wrath, Power of Justice, and Force Field Projection. We go to the villain phase. We add one here and then one more. Then we'll get an attack. So White Tiger will defend. And White Tiger is defeated. Encounter card for this turn is Hydra Sidearm. So we attach it to Taskmaster. And that is that round. Let's go to the next round. I think this time we will start playing with one way or another. We search for a side scheme. Okay, there are none. So that was a bust. Well, it is what it is, so we don't draw the cards. That is unfortunate. I think I will play the Wrath. Then I'll keep the pot shot in hand. What should I do? Our choices here. I think I will port for one, port for one. And that is it. So we ready up. We draw back up. So we get an extra encounter card for decking out. We shuffle our deck. So we have Power of Justice, one way or another, pot shot, Jessica Jones, and pot shot. So we are doing the pot shot twice next round, at least. Or three times if we have the resources. Miss Marvel. We'll go to the villain phase. We add one here and then one more. Taskmaster attacks. I will defend with Moon Knight. And Moon Knight is defeated. We get two encounter cards. We get the Hydra regular and a Hydra soldier. So we add one threat here from the inside. So that is that round. Let's go to the next round. Okay, well, let's see. I think we will use the Power of Justice to play pot shot, so it generates two resources for this. We deal 4 damage, defeating the guard. And we draw an encounter card. Then we will exhaust Miss Marvel, deal 1 damage to get that back into our hand. We'll play it again with the Supernova Helmet. We'll deal 2 here. Then we will attack this for 1. So we ready Supernova Helmet, and we'll use Supernova Helmet to play Potshot again. Dealing 4 here. Then I think that is all we want to do. Let's just use Raid to defeat the Hydra regular. Then we'll ready up. We'll discard this, draw back up to 5. So we get Agile Flight, Jesse Alexander, the Power of Justice, Force Projection, and Jessica Jones. We'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 and 1, so we are at 10. Encounter Taskmaster attacks. I won't defend because we have the force field projection in hand, so 3 plus 1 is 4. We will play this, so when a friendly character will take any amount of damage from attack, prevent 3 of that damage if you paid for this card using a wild resource, deal 3 damage to that enemy. So I'll actually do that. So I'm using the helmet. So we deal 3 here, and we only take 1. So we advance to second phase, deal each player an encounter card, so we get an extra encounter card. And Taskmaster has 16 health. Then we get the encounter cards for this round. First is Mimicry. Discard top 5 cards of your deck. If an attack was discarded, Taskmaster activates 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not an attack, no attacks, not attacks. Well, assault. Miss Marvel will defend. Okay, Miss Marvel is defeated. And Taskmaster shield. So Taskmaster gains retaliate. Exhaust your hero and spend these resources, discard this card. I think we'll have to maybe do that, but that is that round. Let's go to the next round. Before we do anything, we will use Jesse Alexander and the Power of Justice to play Agile Flight. We remove 5 from here. We will go to Alter Ego, and we will heal for 3. And that is our whole turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We get Yo and Roll, Agile Flight. And we draw an extra card, for as this doesn't count, we have Strength, Energy, Force Field Projection, and Jessica Jones. We'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat here. Taskmaster schemes for 2 plus. Again, we are not in hero, so nothing happens. So we add 2 threat here. Encounter card for this turn is Shadow of the Past. So we put Warbringer into play. We get Bring the War. It comes into play with two threats. So when revealed, each player discard one card they control with print. Okay, so we discard connecting to the world mind. So three threat there. And these are shuffled into the encounter deck. So really didn't want to see that Shadows of the Past at this point, but it is what it is, so we'll see how we deal with those. At least Jessica Jones now has a side scheme that gives plus one to her thwarting. But that is that round. Let's go to the next round. Okay, well, I think we'll just flip to hero mode. Then we'll see this, so we'll take one. We'll play Jessica Jones. Yeah. We have a way to defeat that enemy. Okay, let's see. We want to get rid of the shield this round, so... No, we want to play the Agile Flight. So, we are definitely playing Jessica Jones. We'll use Strength. And... your roll. Then we will use the Supernova Helmets and energy to play Agile Flight. We remove 5 from here. Then we will thwart for 2 here, thwart for 1 here, get rid of this. This readies, doesn't matter, but we draw a card. Your unroll, well, yeah, the timing is, this is after, we still drew a card, because Nova exhausted last, so I think we are still in the window to play this, so I'll play this. Remove 3 threat from our scheme. And that is everything. We ready up. We keep the force field projection. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we don't have any wild icons. That is good. And we'll go to the villain phase, we add 1 and 1. Taskmaster attacks, Nova will defend. So we don't take any damage. Warbringer will attack, I'll use Supernova Helmet to play Possible Projection. We deal 3 damage back to that enemy. And... we get an encounter card. It is Hunted by Hydra. Each player in hero form takes 1 damage and discards 1 card at random from their hand. Okay. We lose Wasp. Unfortunately, it's Wasp because we haven't had the chance to play her. But it is what it is, so that is that round. Let's go to the next round. We'll start by using Jessica Jones to defeat the Warbringer. Then I'll play Vikan. And I will thwart for 1, discard card, deal 1 damage here, and this isn't an attack, so it goes past the retaliate. That is our whole turn. We ready up. We draw back to 5. Hot shot. We draw an extra card because of the connecting to the world mind. Light speed flight. Unleash Nova Force. Eros. Helicarrier. We'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat and force add 1 extra. Taskmaster attacks. Jessica Jones will defend. Jessica Jones is defeated. Encounter card is Taskmaster's sword. So now Taskmaster has piercing and plus 1 attack. That is it. So that is that round. Let's go to the next round. Okay, well, I think we just get rid of the shield and try to start dealing as much damage to Taskmaster as possible. So pot shot with the helmet after we just get rid of the... We don't need the light speed, so we can discard that. And helicarrier and exhaust nova. Get rid of the shield. Then we can will thwart for 1, deal 2 damage here. Then we will use the helmet for the pot shot, deal 4 damage here. Use connection to the world mind and unleash Nova Force to play Eros. And we used 1, so we will confuse Taskmaster. Oh, it's only minions, so forget about that. But Eros will attack for 1 damage. That is our turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 5. 2, 3, 4, so we go through our deck a second time. And we get White Tiger, unleash Nova Force, go and roll, light speed, flight, and one way or another. So, actually next round this will be good because we will go through the encounter deck and get those captured by Hydras back into the deck. So, we'll go to the villain phase, we add 1 and force add 1 extra. We will defend with Eros. So, 3 plus 2 plus 1 threat on the main scheme for each card with the printed resource cost in your hand. It is 1. So this is it. At 5, Eros is defeated. Encounter card is, we'll get a boost, acceleration token, shuffle the encounter deck. So, Hydra Soldier and Weapons Master. So, the villain attacks you if they have a weapon attachment, this card gains search. So, they gain search. So, first we attack. I will defend with. I will defend with Weaken. So, Vikan is defeated. It searches for delivery. You may spend a wild resource if you do not, the villain and warbringer attack you, even if you are in alter ego. Do I just let Taskmaster attack me? I really want White Tiger into play. No. I'll use White Tiger or spend. No, I I'll use the helmet. Okay, so that is it. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. First off, we'll use one way or another. We search for a side scheme and we'll grab captured by Hydra. So we get another captured ally. 5 threat. We will play White Tiger. We spent light speed flight. Oh yeah, before we do anything, we'll draw the 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. Now we'll play White Tiger. We'll We will use Agile Flight. So we remove 3, then we will thwart this to remove extra 3. We get Electra. Good. And then we want to play Electra, and we will spend. This guy has guard. So we play Electra. We spend our physical resource. We deal 3 damage on this enemy. We will play Yo and roll to unleash Nova Force. So oh yeah, and we drew a card with that. So we will, yeah, we played Unleash Nova Force, so we get to each time Nova defeats an enemy, we get to ready Nova and draw 1 card. So Nova will defeat the Hydra Soldier. We get to ready Nova, draw a card, Wrath. That's pretty good. We will play Wrath and use the Power of Justice and the helmet. And then we will play Lightspeed Flight. Remove 3 from here. Then we will attack, attack, and attack. For a total of 7 damage, we are 1 away from winning. So 2 consequential here, 1 here, and that is our turn. We ready up. We draw a card, 5 cards. We get energy, light speed, flight. Connection to the world, wind, mind, pot shot, your unroll snow guard. So we are set to defeat Taskmaster next round. We'll go to the villain phase. We add 1 and 4 add 1 and then 1 from here. So that is that. Taskmaster attacks and Wrath will defend. Wrath is defeated. Encounter cards, Hydra regular, insight 1, and combat knife. That doesn't matter. So that is that round. Let's go to the next round. So I think I want to play Snow Guard just for the laughs. So I'll use, well, of course I want to also remove as much threat as possible, so we remove 3. We'll defeat this guy with Electra. We will play. We'll thwart for 1. Yo and roll for 3. then we can use this for to play snow guard. I decide to put one counter on her, so she has 3+ attack, and we will just defeat Taskmaster. So Taskmaster defeated with Nova Justice aerial deck. That was a lot of fun. I think the for this scenario the one way or another are a must. If you're playing Justice, you can just fetch those captured by Hydras. Of course, I think for the first two, I forgot to draw the cards, which is the whole point of the card. But of course, we got those allies with those, so that was pretty good. So, yeah, I think the deck functions really well in true solo. There's enough allies to deal with defending, so you don't have to take that much damage from attacks and go to alter ego all the time. Of course, this scenario brings you cheap allies that just come into play with high stats and stuff like that, but still a decent deck in my opinion. Hope you guys like this playthrough. Thanks for watching, and until next time.